And I understand that the science says that vaccines prevent death. But I'm triple vaxxed, still got COVID. You're triple vaxxed, still got COVID. Why is the president still referring to this as a pandemic of the unvaccinated?
Well, I think, Peter, there's a significant difference between, and you just experienced this, and not to expose your public health experience, but I can speak to mine as well. I had been triple vaxxed. I had minor symptoms. There is a huge difference between that and being unvaccinated. You are 17 times more likely to go to the hospital if you're not vaccinated, 20 times more likely to die. And those are significant, serious statistics. So yes, the impact for people who are unvaccinated is far more dire than those who are vaccinated.
Will the president update his language at some time to be more reflective of the fact that people who are triple vaccinated are catching and spreading COVID?
I think the president has said, as have we a number of times, that there will be breakthrough cases. There will be people who get COVID here at different media organizations, at companies around the world, around the country, who have been vaccinated. But there is a significant difference between being hospitalized or dying and being vaccinated with more mild symptoms.
There's no irony quite like Peter Doocy returning from his bout with COVID to attack safety measures that reduce transmission and severity of COVID. If this was a TV script, the studio would send back notes that it's just too on the nose. Now, Doocy admits here that the science says that the vaccines prevent death, but that transmission can still occur among the vaccinated, and so his issue here is with the semantics of Biden continuing to refer to this pandemic as a pandemic of the unvaccinated, except he answered his own question. Why are Biden and others referring to this as a pandemic of the unvaccinated? Precisely because the unvaccinated are the ones getting hospitalized and dying almost exclusively. Here's a chart of hospitalizations per 100,000 people from New York since Omicron has begun surging. Take a look at this chart and then make the argument that this isn't a pandemic of the unvaccinated. I would imagine that avoiding hospitalization and death are pretty good metrics in terms of how we should be looking at this virus. Since Omicron has been around, the fact is that yes, it's much more transmissible even with the double vaccine and boosters. And so now, just pointing to cases is a far less important metric, while pointing to hospitalizations and deaths is a far more important metric. And so for that reason, it is absolutely still fair to call this a pandemic of the unvaccinated, since virtually all hospitalizations and deaths are among the unvaccinated. And that's obvious, right? I think that all of us by this point know someone who's caught COVID if you haven't caught it yourself. But it's also fair to say that it's less of a big deal if that person was fully vaxxed and boosted and had minor symptoms versus if that person was unvaxxed and ended up on a ventilator in the hospital. But still, despite that obvious point, Doocy presses on and asks if Biden will update his language to be more reflective of the fact that people who are triple vaccinated are catching and spreading COVID. Now, 2 points here. The first is that those who are triple vaccinated are less likely to catch and spread COVID than their unvaccinated counterparts. That's an important distinction because there still is a degree of prevention afforded to you just by virtue of being vaccinated, to say nothing of the protection afforded to you in terms of preventing serious illness. But the second point is the obvious point of Doocy's question here, which is to try and hit the White House with some gotcha, to basically have them admit that the vaccines were useless all along and that you can still catch COVID and that all of the big government lockdowns and shutdowns were worthless, which of course is dripping in bad faith. Why? Because the pandemic is constantly changing. What was true during the Alpha variant is no longer true during the Delta variant, which is no longer true during the Omicron variant. The fact is that vaccinations prevented virtually all breakthrough cases for Delta. That's not true any longer since the virus mutated, although it is true that the vaccine is still extremely effective in preventing serious illness. Anyone approaching this in good faith can obviously see that, and yet that won't stop Republicans like Doocy from trying to manipulate that reality for his own partisan benefit. In fact, Peter Doocy's own father explained that distinction on Fox and Friends.
Here's the thing, you don't trust government, and I get that, and a lot of people don't. However, you know who I trust? I trust my doctor. And in talking to my doctor yesterday about Omicron, and the, you know, the thing about Omicron is the vaccines have not been as effective with that as it was with Delta. And he said, think about it this way, Steve. He said, think of the vaccine as like wearing a Kevlar vest. It is not going to, essentially what the Kevlar vest is gonna do is it's gonna stop a bullet, but it won't let the bullet kill you. And that's why I trust the doctors, I trust the science. You know, It's the only game we got right now is to get vaccinated and boosted. And unfortunately,
Steve, can I ask, is sweeping through the area.
In other words, even Steve Doocy is willing to admit the obvious reality that while these vaccines might not prevent all breakthrough cases with this new Omicron variant, they still do generally prevent hospitalization and death. And no, they're not perfect, but they're pretty damn effective. And beyond that, they're the best we've got right now. So you can either put that Kevlar vest on or not, but if and when you get shot, only one option gives you the best chance for survival. And by the way, this concept isn't new, so let's not pretend that Americans are undergoing some unprecedented imposition on their rights. Seatbelts are the law of the land in this country. Will they prevent you from getting into accidents? No, but they're a hell of a lot more effective in ensuring that you survive if you're in a collision. And yet, the last time I checked, Republicans aren't taking to the streets fomenting anti-seatbelt sentiment because they know seatbelts are effective, just like they know vaccines are effective. The only difference is that they've made the conscious decision to politicize one and not the other. At the end of the day, the fact that there's any of this anti-vax sentiment at all, despite the fact that virtually all deaths are among the unvaccinated, is a clear testament to just how little these Republicans on TV value the lives of their own supporters and viewers. I cannot fathom giving the people who watch these videos advice that would not only put you in danger, but do so in stark contrast to people who've done the opposite. Imagine how that would reflect on me. So you can either get vaccinated and boosted and be almost assured to survive, or you can reject the vaccines and risk being part of the group of Americans that is almost unilaterally dying from this virus. That Fox is telling its audience on a daily basis to distrust the vaccine is all the proof you need that those deaths are a small price for them to be able to pay to exploit yet another culture war issue that they rely on to succeed. To see more videos like this, click the subscribe button right here on this screen. And if you want to support my work, subscribe to my podcast, No Lie with Brian Tyler Cohen. I cover the most important stories each week, and my guest is always one of the top political figures, including Vice President Kamala Harris, Jen Psaki, Elizabeth Warren, Pete Buttigieg, Nancy Pelosi, Katie Porter, Cory Booker, and so many more. The podcast link is also right here on this screen, so give it a listen and subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you listen to podcasts.